I have a four-year-old daughter who has a rare neurological condition. Now, she's in preschool at the moment. She's only just turned four. But in 12 months' time, she's going to be starting school. And I am very worried as a parent, if they're cutting SNA positions this year, and we know they're cutting 227 positions, what is the situation going to be like in 12 months down the line when there's even more children coming into the school system, as obviously there are every year? Is there going to be help for my daughter? Is she actually going to be able to get an education? So that's why we drove over to Mullingar and got the train down to Dublin yesterday in the heat.
In the heat, but it absolutely looked lovely in Dublin yesterday with the sun shining and the groups, particularly mothers, I have to say, up there with their children.
Yeah. It's hard. I mean, my husband was hoping to join us, but he couldn't get the day off work. You know, there's a recession on, people have to hang on to their jobs. It is primarily mothers who are full-time carers, although I do know some fathers who are full-time carers of children with disabilities. It was a fantastic day. It was very hot. The children behaved brilliantly. We were there outside Dáil Éireann for nearly just over 2 hours, myself and my little daughter. She was in her pushchair the whole time on a hot day, not really understanding what was going on, and she was laughing and clapping her hands and joining in with the shouting and had a great time. But, you know, the thing is, it's so wrong that we actually have to do this. I mean, yes, it was a lovely sunny day. I should have been able to take her to the park or go for an ice cream, you know, the kind of things you do with your kids in the summertime. But instead, loads of us from all over the country travelled the journey to Dublin to stand there in the heat, in the sun, and say to our national parliament, you cannot do this to our children. Our children have a right to an education. And by, you know, allegedly saving this money, which they reckon they're going to save by cutting these SNA positions now, in some cases, all they're doing is going to lead to children not getting the education they deserve, not getting the help they need, and not being able to live as independent a life in years to come. So they're actually possibly going to need to go into institutional care as adults, which is going to cost the state even more. So it's a completely short-sighted step.
Do you think, Tracy, that the visual impact of having children, and in particular children with a lot of them with disabilities in wheelchairs, that that visual impact was vital to drive home your message yesterday?
I think it was, because not so much for the politicians, I mean, how much attention they actually paid us, I don't know, but certainly in terms of media, we're trying to reach out to the whole country and say, look, you know, this is what is being done. This is what is happening. These are the people. These are the children who are being affected. And it's also very hard for a parent of a child with special needs, whether they're in a wheelchair or not, to actually organise yourself to make that trek to Dublin to stand there and protest. And also, let's be realistic, it does help us get better media coverage. You know, children are appealing to look at. But we're not doing it as a cynical measure. We're doing it to say these are the people who are being hurt by this measure. It's very easy for me to go on the radio or to go on the TV and say, yes, my daughter, blah, blah, blah. But if someone can actually see her and see how great she is and how well she's doing and think, well, that child is going to need a lot of help, and she's got the right to have it, it just helps get the message across more clearly, I think.
Well, did you talk to other parents yesterday who have already felt the effects of cutbacks, whose kid would have had SNA help, but now hasn't got SNA help or has reduced hours?
Yeah, I did. I mean, I could quote you 1,000 cases, but there's two in particular, both from the Midlands region, actually. One is a mum who has 5-year-old twins. Now, a boy and a girl. Her little girl is perfect, no issues at all, and she goes to her local national school and she toddles off every day very happy. Her twin brother has severe to profound level of disability and he goes to a special school. He's been going to school since last September, and in March he lost his SNA or access to his SNA for 29 days because the position was cut. He can't talk, he can't walk, he's in nappies full time, he has very limited communication. How is he supposed to communicate? I need my nappy changed, I'm tired, I'm hungry, I'm thirsty, whatever his needs might be, if he doesn't have someone there watching out for him all the time. So that's one case. And another case I know, again, another Midlands family, their little daughter is due to start national school this September coming. She'll be 5 in August, and she has a much milder level of disability and is able to go to mainstream school, but she does need an SNA because, again, her mobility is restricted. She can walk, but she can't run, for example. She's in nappies. Her communication is quite good, but it's not as good as most children her age. So she needs that extra bit of help. And they had to wait. They just heard that she is going to have an SNA. But it got to the stage, they didn't know if they were going to be able to send her to school in September, because they didn't hear up until, I think it was Monday of this week, that she was actually going to have that SNA. Now, the stress that puts on a family is just intolerable. And it's disgraceful that in this day and age, parents are saying, God, can I actually send my child to school? Because they just need this extra bit of help, but if it's not there, they can't go.
In the Dáil, Enda Kenny stood up and he said that no school will be without contact of an SNA if they need it, and no child will be without contact with an SNA.
But the term contact is very interesting, Clara. Contact can mean that you might have two children in two separate classrooms who are sharing one SNA. Now, if one of those children is in the process of having their nappy changed by an SNA, which can happen, and the other child, we say, for example, has a communication issue and is getting frustrated and upset because they can't get their needs across, what is that SNA supposed to do? She, and they are primarily women, you know, are supposed to cover two different classrooms. I mean, physically they can't be in one place, two places at once. So contact is a term I'm very uncomfortable with, because it sounds great, oh, they'll have contact with an SNA, but in reality we need him to spell out, what does that actually mean? Is every child who needs an SNA going to be able to have their SNA when they need it? And when he says contact, I am not hopeful. There's another case, for example, of a child who, again, is severe to profoundly disabled, who has been told, his mother has been told, that he can go, he will have access to an SNA for 1 hour a day, so he can go to school for 1 hour a day because he has very, very high needs. 1 hour a day. I mean, it's actually staggering. If it was fiction, nobody would believe it. Where we go from here? Well, there is going to be a meeting, there's incessant meetings all the time, but there's going to be a meeting of the Special Needs Parents Association, of which I'm a member. I'm not a representative of theirs, I'm just a member of theirs, sometime later on in the summer, where we're going to plan our next steps. We are talking all the time amongst ourselves by email, on Facebook and so on.
Tracy, thank you very much for taking our call.